Okay, this is not image URL, actually it is song URL. So let me quickly change that, because we have already defined that URL for image here as a cover image. So song URL, so I'm gonna change that to song URL here as well. Now I'm gonna assign the data that we have received through this object to the field that we have created here inside this class. So I can use this keyboard for that. So this title equals to title, and I will repeat the same thing for all the variable that we have here. Okay, the finally now we need to generate the setter and getter. Instead of doing that manually, we can use the automatic feature that we have in the Android Studio. So right click on the right click here and go to generate, and here we have the setter and getter. Click on that, select all the fields and click on OK. It will automatically generate the setter and getter. And if you don't know what is setter and getter, the setter is used to set the data. So if we create the empty object of this song, then we can later refer the set title method of this setter to assign the title to our object. Okay, so this is used to create the data manually, and getters are used to return the data that we have already assigned to the object. Go back to the main activity, because this is it for this object. Before working on extracting the data from JSON file, let's work on this adapter here, because I have left few things incomplete here. Here we will extract the data that is passed to the adapters while creating the adapter object, as I said. So for that we need a constructor, and we need layout inflator. So I'm gonna create a new layout inflator here. We'll also create a list of song, and that is called the songs. Okay, so this list of songs will contain all the songs that we extracted from the JSON file. Now I'm gonna create the constructor for this adapter class. And this adapter class will take the context as a parameter, as well as the list of songs. Okay, so this generic list can have the data only the object of song class. Okay, so I'm gonna assign this as I have done before. I'm gonna get the layout inflator from the context that is passed through the adapter, so that is CTX, and I'm gonna assign the songs that is received from the adapter instance. Okay, so this is how we assign the receive the data from the main activity and assign to our adapter. Now we can bind this data to the view that we have, custom view. So here I'm gonna create the new view, and this view will inflate the custom layout resources that we have created. So r.layout and the custom list layout. Now we need to pass the view group and the false as a attached to root. Now I'm gonna create a new instance of view holder, and that will take the view as a parameter which we have just created. Now we'll come back to this unbind view holder afterwards. So let's go back to this inner class here, and inside this I can create the instances of the data that we have. So this is the cover image, title and artist name. Bind the data to that custom view components. I can create the instances of that component here. I'm going to create the text view here, and song title and song artist, and we need one more component, that is image view for cover image. Let me say song cover image, that will be more descriptive. Now inside this view holder we can instantiate that with the XML resources that we have. Now we need to use the view that is passed through the onCreate view holder. So that is item view in our case. So item view dot find view by ID, and inside this I can get the ID of the song title text view. Similarly, I can do for song artist and song cover image. Okay, now these external resources are attached to the variable that we have created here. Now we can bind that data to these components, and we'll do that in the unbind view holder. To bind the data, we need to use the view holder that is passed through this unbind view holder method. So holder dot, we can select any of the variable that we have created inside this view holder class. So that is song title, and I will use the set text method of this text view, and inside this I can pass the title of the song, and that will be reflected in our custom list layout here. Okay, here. So now you may be wondering, how do we get the title of the song? So you, if you remember here, we have this list of songs here, and this list of songs have the song object. So each object will have its own title, cover image, artist, and all the information we need. Okay, so we can refer by using the this list of array here, and the position and based on the position that is clicked. Okay, so based on the position that we have in the list, we will display the data. So we have the position here. So let me get the information that is song title. So songs is the list we have, and then we can use the get method of this song, and we can pass the index or position. So by writing this many line of code, we are getting the one single object here on that particular position, and that will, that object will have the setter and getter that we have set in the song class. So I can use dot notation to get that getters, call that getters. So here I need the titles, so I'm going to get the titles. So get title, right? And similarly, I can get the artist, song URL, and the other information that we need. So let me do that for the artist as well. Song artist dot set text and songs dot get position dot get artist. Okay, and similarly I can get the image view, and similarly I can set the image. But to set the image, we need to use the Picasso library. So let me go to the my browser here and get the dependency for the Picasso library. Okay, Picasso GitHub, and in the from the Picasso GitHub library, we can get the dependencies URL. Copy this, go back to the builder Gradle file of our project. Here, just after card view, I'm gonna paste the dependencies URL and sync the project. Once the project is synced, we are ready to use Picasso on our project. So let me go back to the adapter here, and once the sync is done, it is still going. Okay, now it is done, we can use the Picasso. So I'm gonna use Picasso, Picasso class dot get dot load. Now here I need to provide the URL, and that URL we have received from the JSON data. By using the same object, I can get the URL songs dot get dot position and dot get song, sorry, get cover image. Okay, so it will return the URL. Inside this, I need to provide the image view component that we have created, and by using holder I can create provide that, so song cover image. Okay, so these are the three things that we want to display in the custom list layout. These are the all the things that we need to do here in the adapter for this project. Now let's get back to the main activity, and here we will start using the Volley. So Volley is a HTTP library which is used for the networking on Android application, and it will do the networking very efficiently. So if you see the older videos on YouTube about the JSON extraction and JSON parsing, you will see that a lot of people are using async task. Actually, Volley is a open source application, and it was available in the GitHub, and Google officially announced that it is going to use Volley to do that kind of thing instead of using manual async task. By using async task, you can have the more control over your task, but Volley for general use, Volley is really efficient. I recommend you guys to do use the same thing. But if you have the large number of data to extract from the JSON, like thousands of songs, then it is not recommended. Then you can use other library of Android Studio called Download Manager. So for this video, we have like 10 or 20 songs, so we'll be using Volley, so it will be more easier for us to use the Volley. So I'm gonna start by creating the instance of Recycler View. So let me do that, Recycler View, and I'll just say Recycler View. And we also need list, because we need to pass the list of songs while creating the adapter object. So it's better that I'll create right now, and I'm just gonna say songs. And we need the URL of the JSON file. So the URL of JSON file is, we have here this starlaw.hackerorg.com/studio. So let me copy this. If you have other JSON URL, you can copy that URL and paste it here. I will also create the instance of adapter class here, because we need that later in the video, so it's better that I create right now. Now inside this, I'm gonna link the recycler view to the external resources that we have. So recycler view, find PYID r.id, and the song list is the ID of the recycler view that we have created. So in the, that is in the activity main. So this is this list. Now I'm gonna create the new array list for the songs that we have created there. New array list. Now finally we can start extracting the data from the URL that we have given here. And to do that, I'm gonna create the one method that says extract song. And I'm gonna create this method inside this main activity. The volley work closely with request queue, because request queue is really essential here, because it is going to manage the number of requests, and it is going to extract the data and parse the data. And volley will take care of populating the data in the UI. So we are going to start by creating the request queue. And now by using volley class, I can create the new request queue, and I need to pass the context as a parameter. Now, since we are working on the JSON data, we need to create new JSON array request here.